Hi friends, in this video we are going to see symmetric, or you can say even, anti-symmetric, or you can say odd signals. This is one of the basic topic in signals and systems. First we will see what is meant by symmetric or anti-symmetric signal. A signal that is signals may exhibit symmetric or anti-symmetric with respect to t is equal to 0 for a continuous time system signals, or n is equal to 0 for discrete time signal. When a signal can be said to be a symmetric signal, a signal exhibits a symmetric with respect to t is equal to 0 for continuous time signal, or n is equal to 0 for discrete time signal, then it is a even signal or symmetric signal. Therefore, a even signal satisfies the following condition. For continuous time signal means x of minus t should be equal to x of t. This is the condition for symmetry for a continuous time signal. See here, this is x of t signal. Here, time t is equal to some positive x of t, we can say this is x of t, this is positive side and this is negative side. So, x of t is equal to x of, for example, this is 2 seconds. Then it is minus 2 seconds means x of t is equal to x of minus t. Otherwise, I can say x of minus t that is equal to x of t. So, any signal which exhibits this symmetric nature, then it is called even signal. For example, we know that cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta. This is the example for a symmetric signal. Right? Similarly, for discrete time system, this is x of 0, this is x of 0. So, x of n, this is x of n means this is x of minus n. So, x of minus n is equal to x of n. This is x of minus 2, it is equal to x of 2. X of minus 3 is equal to x of 3. So, this signal exhibits the symmetry. So, it is symmetric or even signal. Next, you will see anti-symmetry. When a signal exhibits anti-symmetry with respect to t for a continuous time signal, n is equal to 0 for discrete time signal, then it is called odd signal. See the condition for anti-symmetric or odd signal. For continuous time signal, x of minus t should be equal to minus of x of t. Minus of x of t. See here, this is x of t. For example, if you are saying this is 5 seconds, this is x of t. X of minus t, this is minus 5. So, this is equal to minus of this value. This is a. For x of t, this is a means this is x of minus t is minus a. So, it is anti-symmetric. This is anti-symmetric. They are symmetric, but the value is opposite. Magnitude is opposite. Okay. The magnitude is equal, but they are opposite. Then it is anti-symmetric. Similarly, for discrete time system, x of minus n should be equal to x of n. See here, this is x of 1 and this is x of minus 1. X of minus 1 is equal to x of 1. What is x of 1? 2. X of 1 is 2. Here it is minus 2, minus 1, minus 3. Like similarly, x of 2, this is x of minus 2. So, x of minus 2 is equal to what? X of 2 is 1. X of minus 2 is minus 1. So, this is the condition. X of minus n should be equal to minus of x of n. X of minus n. That is x of minus 2 is minus 1. That is x of minus 2 is x of 2, that is 1, then minus. Okay. So, this is anti-symmetric. Similarly, I told you for the continuous time system, this is magnitude will be equal, but they are opposite, that is anti-symmetric, right? So, sine minus theta, this is the example, sinusoidal signal is the example for anti-symmetric signal or odd signal. Cosinusoidal signal is the example for, this is cosinusoidal signal. This is cosinusoidal signal. This is the example for symmetric signal, right? Just we have represented this value as a signal. So, x of minus 3, this is x of minus 2, x of 1, this is x of 0, then this is x of 1, x of 2, x of 3. So, x of minus 3 will be equal to minus of x of 3. Minus of x of 3 is 3, the minus will be, this is minus 3. Okay, x of minus 3 is minus 3. This will be equal to minus of x of 3. That is the condition for anti-symmetry, right? Next, any signal, you can say any signal can be represented as summation of odd and even signal. Summation of odd and even signal. This is for continuous time signal means x of t is equal to even part of x of t, then odd part of x of t. Similarly, for discrete time signal, x of n is represented as a summation of even and odd signal. Right? x e of t is even part of x of t, and x0 of t is x o of t, you can say x o of t is odd part of the x of t, right? So, we can prove that x e of t, that is 1 by 2 x of t plus x of minus t. These formulas are really important for solving the problem. So, odd part of x of t, even part of x of t, that is equal to 1 by 2 x of t plus x of minus t. Similarly, for odd part of x of t, that is x o of t, that is equal to 1 by 2 x of t minus x of minus t. Similarly, for discrete time signal, x e of n is equal to 1 by 2 x of n plus x of minus n, x o of n is equal to 1 by 2 x of n minus x of minus n. These formulas are really important. Okay. Next, the properties of signals with the symmetry. For even signal, odd part is 0. If it is a pure even signal, means I told you any signal can be represented as a summation of even signal and odd signal. As I told you here, this is the even signal. This is even signal. So, this even signal does not have any odd part. Similarly, this is odd signal. This signal will not have any even part. But any signal can be represented as a summation of even and odd signal. Similarly, for odd signal, there will not be any even part. Even part is 0. Odd signal and odd signal, if you are product, the product of odd signal and odd signal will give you even signal, right? Similarly, even signal and even signal will give you the even signal, product will be even signal. Then odd signal and even signal product will be give you odd signal. You can just remember, minus into minus will give you minus, plus. Then plus into plus will give you plus. Then minus into plus will give you minus. You can just remember like this, right? So, you can compare, odd signal is a minus signal and even signal is a positive signal. Okay. So, minus into minus will give you plus, plus into plus will give you plus, minus into plus will give you minus. So, this is the thing. So, this is all about what is even or odd signal, okay. And this formula is really important, okay, and this property also important. On the next video, we will see some example problems related to even and odd signals. Thank you very much.